We said farewell to the 2018-2019 season and welcomed in the new term at Dubbo on Sunday. And there were plenty of highlights in between showcased in this edition of The Week That Was. Starting out at Bathurst last Wednesday, which was a memorable night for young driver Kelly Munro, who landed her first win thanks to this performance by Dynamite D.
Dynamite D, though, moves up on the outside and goes straight on by. Dynamite D, Bill Shannon rallies late. Dynamite D, Kelly Munro's first winner. Dynamite D.
Not much happened in Sydney for the next couple of days, with both Penrith and Bankstown meetings abandoned due to wet weather, but racing still went ahead at Young on Friday. Driver Nathan Turnbull edged closer to driving 400 winners thanks to this effort by Abercrombie Flash. The two-year-old filly took on the older horses.
On the outside of it then is Pete's Bet Rock, but halfway down the straighter, it's going to be far too good, the little two-year-old. She's going well. She scores by two, Abercrombie Flash.
This is 408, also winning at Young on Friday. The gelding secured the fastest win on the program, clocking 157.2, which was his fifth win for the season in 17 starts.
But it's a one-horse affair halfway down the straighter, and 408 comes away to score well, scored by six. Second placing, Gerarda's Delighter. Third will be Streamliner ahead of Arrow Keith.
With rain affecting Newcastle's meeting on Saturday, the only meeting for the night in New South Wales was at Menangle. It was the last Metropolitan meeting for the season, and the McCarthy brothers Luke and Todd wasted no time putting on a show, driving a couple of winners each. Todd made sure he secured the Metropolitan Drivers' Premiership in the process.
Power Surge goes up to join the leaders. A bit more Bliss is starting to hit top gear. Spike Robin probes for a middle split, but the leader, Power Surge, it's Power Surge holding them at bay. Out late, Convair Hustler, but too late.
There were also two Group 2 APG Championship finals at Menangle on Saturday night, with La La Bron breaking her maiden in the filly's leg, and Expensive Ego remaining unbeaten in six starts with this career best effort.
He just livens him up, this excitement machine, Expensive Ego, going for six out of six, and he's got it, and a Group 2 to boot.
Art Major gelding Island Special Major caused a massive upset, beating Inter-Dominion champion Tiger Tara, while Father and Son duo Steve and Mitch Turnbull combined to secure the Pink Diamond Stakes.
Any number of chances. We're out wide. Casuarina Belma goes up to look for the lead with Kiama's Rosie. It's on the outside. Casuarina Belma hitting the lead. Casuarina Belma's going to beat Kiama's Rosie. Pete's Art Major Cam's Pearl.
The last meeting in New South Wales for the season was taken out by Evergreen Trotter Sunset Tour for trainers Joe and Mary Rando and driver Cameron Hart, who ended up being the state's leading concession driver for the term.
Getting up on the inside of Sunset Tour, it's Amanda Spur trying to stave them all off. Out later, Sunset Tour finishing brilliantly. Sunset Tour out after Amanda Spur's got it. Sunset Tour went home. Sunset Tour has won the last race for the 2018-2019 season.
The new season was welcomed in at Dubbo on Sunday afternoon, and driver John O'Shea wasted no time landing a treble. This is John sealing his hat trick with Joey Liu.
Picked them up in a couple of strides, whisked on by, and's going to get the prize. Joey Liu coming down to the line, John O'Shea, three winners for the day. He's on top of the point score here after our first meeting.
A treble was replicated at Menangle on Tuesday too, with Luke McCarthy taking the driving honours thanks to wins with La La Bron, Mongolian Archer, and as you can see here, Admiral Bronski.
Cool Hand Luke going for three for the program, and with 75 metres left to go, he's got Smoky Quartz's measure. They leave it in there, and it's Admiral Bronski for the money.
The Don Boston was also too good for his rivals, producing this win and rating 152.6. That was win number 32 for the 11-year-old gelding.
Gage almost hitting empty for the Don. It's Don Boston, 100 to go. A passion for races is inch by inch cutting back the margin. Don still in front. Don Boston lifts. Don Boston does it.
And that was another edition of The Week That Was. Thanks for watching.